Willow here with Fruits Basket's reboot out now. It's high time I finally do a review of this spectacular reboot to my favorite shoujo manga ever made. Roll that intro and let's get started. Toru Honda is a high school student who recently lost her mom after a fatal car accident killed her. So now she lives alone in a tent in the woods, but remains optimistic because her mom was fucking awesome. On her way to school, she meets Shigure and Yuki Soma, and eventually gets to live with them and learn the crazy curse of the Soma family. The Soma family are cursed where, as soon as someone of the opposite gender hugs them, they turn into their respective animal of the Chinese zodiac. It's a secret no one's supposed to know, but Toru does by accident, but promises not to tell a soul. The series then focuses on Toru, Kyo, and Yuki, who all must keep it hidden and learn to live with the Soma curse. I know, I'm surprisingly simplifying it, but Fruits Basket is one of those series way too brilliant to spoil, so I'm keeping things fairly vague. Now, while this was the plot of the original anime, keep in mind that this is now following the manga, and I could already tell you that there's a certain foreshadowing that the original anime never kept in the first place they're doing. Now, while the story is truly brilliant and immensely emotional, I tell you, 3 episodes in and I was already getting pretty emotional watching it, I've seen some people complain that it's not as funny as the original anime, and I think that's because no one actually read the manga outside of the first 2 volumes. Once a certain plot point happens with Kyo, the manga makes a huge shift in tone from pure comedy to a more romantic drama with bits of comedy to keep it at a lighthearted pace. The reason why Shigure isn't a pervert anymore, why Kyo's bursts of anger aren't as dramatic, is because both characters don't get that way, so to reflect that, they dropped those elements altogether. The more serious and dramatic tone is just so there's not a disconnect between the 2 major plot points, as I know some people who did read the manga felt like a tonal disconnect once that plot point with Kyo happens. Even if it does go for a more serious aspect, I do think the story is genuinely brilliant. Not only are there heavy themes of loss and moving on, but also themes of isolation and the trauma of mental abuse, which is extremely important. You know, I had once read from a Japanese Fruits Basket fan about how important Fruits Basket actually is for a lot of Japanese readers. Currently, mental abuse from family is very high in Japan, given how disastrous and honestly toxic Japan views how a proper home life should be. So to see characters given those situations learn to grow and live their own lives instead of letting it eat at them is extremely important for anyone who has come from an abusive home at some point in their lives. Also, if Clannad made y'all cry, then you need to see this story because I think it gives Clannad a run for its money. I don't want to go in depth because, again, trying to avoid spoilers here, but I love them all. I mean, there's already one I expressed in my top 10 anime characters I hate video that I despise with every fiber of my being, but still, aside from that one, I love all of them. The thing that makes Fruits Basket so emotional is the characters. They're all quirky and adorable in their own way that you can't help but love them and want to root for them, that they'll have an actually happy life. Though I did notice one particular thing that I was happy to see. Yuki went through a drastic change. See, what many people didn't know because of the original anime, but Yuki can be kind of a petty asshole in the original manga. While sure, he's nice to Toru and the other classmates, the shock for Yuki, since he's constantly been labeled the prince, is that he's actually selfish, petty, and an envious person. The thing about why this is important to Yuki is to show us that even though he pretends like the Soma House didn't impact him, it's this shift in personality from the perfect high school student to someone who can be extremely petty to others, and suddenly learning to grow as a person from that, I think is something needed for anyone to see. Another thing I did like, and forgive me for some minor spoilers here, even though it's just a character building thing and nothing else, was Momiji finally speaking some gosh damn German. I know it's a minor character detail literally everyone forgets, but I found him speaking German to be absolutely an adorable character trait. There's just something super charming about already cute characters speaking in an alternate language when they're excited that is just the sweetest thing to exist. Overall, the characters are amazing and you will come out loving either everyone or at least a handful. Now, I know some have said that the new art style looks a bit too narrow or something like that, but I think the art style is beautiful. Sure, it doesn't match the later soft coloring and designs of the author's artwork later on, but I still think it's a beautiful fit for the manga. It's actually kind of like an immensely upgraded version of the original art style, but also to reflect the huge improvement Fruits Basket's art style had during the run of its manga. There's really no negatives I can give on it either, just praising how fucking gorgeous it is, and I love that finally Yuki has some gray hair instead of purple hair and eyes, because purple totally makes sense for a rat, am I right? Thanks to the change in style, I feel the characters reflect more the animal they represent for the most part. There's nothing else I can say about it other than it is truly beautiful. If y'all thought that Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood was the best adaptation for a shonen manga ever made, Fruits Basket's reboot is the best adaptation for a shoujo manga. Sorry, Sailor Moon, I fucking adore you, but your original anime made up shit that didn't make any sense, or your reboot was really fucking ugly, but also I think your reboot got cancelled. Or unforgive me, you were faithful as fuck, but you never made a second goddamn season and now I'm sad forever. With this reboot, this is the definitive version to watch Fruits Basket. Not only is it fucking gorgeous, but the original dub cast makes a return for the official dub, and everyone does an amazing job. Okay, not everyone returns, since some voice actors aren't voice actors anymore, and other voice actors were actual children when they voiced the characters, and other characters needed to be replaced for certain events later on. But other than that, most of the dub cast makes a return. But anyway, this is truly a beautiful version of my favorite shoujo manga, and I highly recommend everyone please watch it. I know it's 3 episodes in, and I shouldn't be praising it so much because it could be like Dororo and suddenly turn into a suspicious shit. But I can tell this is gonna be very beautiful anime. You know what? Fuck it. I'll just say that it'll be more than a beautiful anime. This will be anime of the year. I can feel it in my gosh damn bones. Here's to hoping Ouran gets its reboot, because come on, let the second best shoujo manga ever made finally tell its full story too, damn it. Hey guys, thanks for watching! If you liked the video, then be sure to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you're new! And if any old or new subs would like to help support the channel in any way, then feel free to visit my Ko-fi page down below in the description, along with my social media tabs. For any subscribers, new or old, who'd like to help with video ideas or maybe want to talk about anime or something, then I have a fan server linked down below. See you next time!